Hello and welcome to yet another exciting episode of Zee Connect Season 2. Are you connected? पल भर में टूट जाए वो कसम नहीं, दोस्त को भूल जाए वो हम नहीं, आप हमें भूल जाए इस बात में दम नहीं, क्योंकि आप हमें भूल जाए इतने बुरे हम नहीं. And that is why we not only come to entertain you, but we also come and spend time with you. And what better way to start this evening by giving you all a glimpse of everything that's happening in your city with the front page.
Emiratis and expatriates will soon be able to complete their paperwork in government offices in Dubai easily and in less time, as they will not be required to enter their personal details while filling in new applications. All government departments in Dubai will be able to electronically access data about residents. Dubai e-government has signed an agreement with the Emirates Identity Authority to support government integration and particularly the improvement of operational performance. Residents of Dubai now risk losing facilities as communities cut corners to balance the hike in utility bills. Homeowners who have bought apartments in certain new Dubai communities in the hope of getting good rental returns have been stumped by high service fees and rising utility costs. Of late, there has been an almost 50% increase in utility bills of communities that run on district cooling. As a result, the service fee charges in these communities have gone up too. In order to keep the charges down, many communities have been forced to cut down on other services. His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, President of the UAE and ruler of Abu Dhabi, has granted 500,000 dirhams for every player of the UAE football team in recognition for their qualifications to the London 2012 Olympics. His Highness extended his congratulations to the national team on their historic achievement in securing the UAE's first qualification to the Olympics.
In every conceivable manner, the family is a link to our past and bridges our future. And we here at Zee Family leave no stone unturned in bridging our future ties with all of you by coming to your homes and spending some quality time with all of you. We meet people, we greet people, but at Zee Family, we connect with people. This week on Zee Family, we have the Shahs. And let's have a quick introduction from them. Hi ma'am, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm Zareen.
I'm Zafar.
I'm Alia.
And I'm Samir.
So tell me something about yourself.
I'm a hotelier. We run a chain in Dubai. And I spend all my time in work and the rest of the time with my family.
Most of the time in the morning time I leave, when the kids go to school we drop them ourselves, and then I go to work, and I always finish my work when they finish school, so I always go and collect them and then I spend the rest of the time with them.
Tell me, what does family mean to you all?
When we go home, I sit by my mother and we watch the CTV and the soaps is going on. It's all ladies and the dramas. And about 2 hours, 2.5 hours every day I spend with my mother watching the CTV.
Because we are all very busy, even when they are home, they have to do their schoolwork, prepare for tests or exams. So most of the time they are busy in their own activities, but the dinner time of course is the family time. And of course when we finish our work, of course we watch TV, we sit together and watch movies as well on the cinema at the weekends, especially if there is a good movie on that the whole family watches together.
What does ZTV mean to you all?
ZTV is another connecting families. You know, you learn a lot about the families, the values, what they do back home in India. And obviously, we've been in Dubai for a long time. We miss our festivals. We miss our holis. We miss our Eid festivals. So obviously, we're watching every day the Z program, and that's what you see, the holi, you don't miss. You don't miss Ramadan. You don't miss Eid holidays. So obviously, it's connecting. is connecting home away from home. So that's what I feel Z is providing us in Dubai, and obviously the expats who is living away from home, this is the media who's providing these facilities, so we don't miss, we don't get homesick.
First, I started watching ZTV when Sameer wasn't born, like about 14 years ago, when the program I used to watch was Amanat. Very good episode was about to come, I think 35th or something, and then I was in the hospital when Sameer was born, and I missed that. And I always wanted sometime they repeat this program again. I wish, but they didn't. And since then, we always have ZTV in our house.
Z family, I belong.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure talking to all of you. And if you wish to be on ZTV, all you got to do is subscribe to the Z Family package or do write in to us at zfamily@mirazztv.com. We truly believe that in order to have a healthy life, you need to have a healthy mind. And in order to have a healthy and fresh mind, all you got to do is just answer our simple, fully fried question. Well, this week, we decided to test your IQ. Do any one of you know that in which part of the world is Timbuktu located in?
Timbuktu, no, I don't know.
No.
Some Asian place?
No, I don't know.
You have to give an option for that.
Somewhere in the desert, no idea where.
India?
It's an illusion created by media, that's it. Nothing else.
I thought it's in Timbuktu.
No idea.
Right here.
Maybe somewhere in this world.
Maharashtra.
I don't have any idea about that one. What is that?
Timbuktu should be in India, if I'm not mistaken.
I have no idea. I have to be honest. I have no idea.
Global village, maybe? No.
No idea.
Festival city, then.
It's nowhere in the world. Am I right?
In New Zealand.
Maybe somewhere in Dubai.
Or Australia.
Just heard the name, like, but we don't know where it is.
India?
It's in Mali.
Somewhere in Africa.
It's in Africa.
Well, meri bhi geography itni achhi nahi hai. So I think I need a short break after that question answer round. But you don't go anywhere, because I'm going to be right back with your favorite segment, UAE-centric. Until then, stay connected.